It is October in India, and there's a slight nip in the air. As I walk through thick rice fields, I notice a thick blanket of smoke hovering above in the distance. I follow the sight and smell of the smoke, and chance upon a group of farmers standing next to a large inferno. Curious to know more, I meet Kuldeep. Kuldeep has 3 tons of rice straw left over in his farm after harvest, which is of no use to him, and has to get rid of it within a week before planting the next crop. He burns them in the open, as that is the cheapest and fastest way. The smoke lingers in the air for days, affecting the health of his community. He was recently fined 5,000 rupees or $70 by the local government, which was 25% of his income for the harvest season. However, this problem is not witnessed in agricultural lands alone. It can be witnessed in a forest too. It is peak summer, not even sparing the middle Himalayas. Soothing views of the mountains during my road journey is suddenly interrupted by the views of a forest fire engulfing a hillside. Deepa Devi's village is located right next to a dense pine forest. Deepa is a subsistence farmer whose only source of income is daily wage labor, which is often not available. Every summer, the monoculture pine forest next to a village sheds pine needles to the forest floor and fuels ravaging forest fires that not only is a threat to her village, but also destroys local biodiversity. The forest fires replace pristine air of the mountains with smoke for the village community. Such forest fires are now observed in many other parts of the world as well, such as the Pacific West Coast, Australia, and Greece. Just like Kuldeep and Deepa, there are millions of farmers worldwide who have a hard time dealing with their agricultural and forest waste. It is estimated that worldwide, close to 5 billion tons per year of agricultural and forest waste, such as rice straws, rice husks, coconut shells, sugarcane trash, etc., is burned in the open. I grew up in New Delhi. I remember my grandfather getting so sick from the air pollution that he found it hard to breathe. In 2016, around Diwali, the air quality became so bad with harmful particles that it went beyond the measurement capabilities of most measurement instruments. Recent studies estimate that the open burning of agricultural and forest waste contribute up to 25% of smog in urban centers such as Delhi, where I currently live, leading to as many as 1 in 8 deaths in countries such as India, and reducing the affected population's life expectancy by up to 5 years. This is not something we just heard about. We are living it every single day. However, this is a solvable problem. There's a way for farmers like Deepa and Kuldeep to use their farm and forest waste productively, prevent harmful smoke emissions, while at the same time create $130 billion per year of economic value for rural communities worldwide. But what is new here? We already know that agricultural and forest waste can be used to make valuable products such as fuels and fertilizers. However, the utilization is just not scaling quickly. Now, why is this so? The answer lies in the nature of these wastes itself. They are loose, wet, and bulky, and of low economic value, thus making them very expensive to transport and process. Now imagine. Imagine machines that enable Kuldeep and Deepa to become entrepreneurs and earn extra income by turning their locally available agricultural and forest waste into valuable products such as fuels and fertilizers while preventing harmful smoke emissions. Me and my co-founder Kevin built Takachar to realize this impact. Our team at Takachar feels very passionate about this injustice and missed opportunity. Over the past few years, we have developed small-scale, low-cost, smoke-free, and portable equipment that can be latched behind tractors and even bullock carts and taken directly to the sites where these agricultural and forest wastes are located. The machine then processes this waste into dense carbon-rich fuels and fertilizers within 30 minutes. So how does this work? Our equipment works similar to cooking. It heats these wastes in controlled amounts of air, taking out low energy containing molecules and leaving behind a dense carbon-rich material. This process is known as oxygen-lean torrefaction. The machine is easy to operate, maintain, and does not require any external source of energy for heating, thereby making it suitable to be deployed in remote rural areas. Our tests show that our equipment can reduce up to 95% of smoke emissions as compared to open burning of these wastes. Above all, decentralized deployment of our equipment gives control to farmers to create value. If our equipment is deployed in Deepa or Kuldeep's village, not only do they stand to benefit by becoming local business owners, but also create an ecosystem where other farmers from the village can sell the waste to them and earn up to 30% more income for the harvest season. Working with agricultural and forest waste can have numerous benefits. It can lead to rural value creation, pollution mitigation, preventing and removing carbon emissions, and create resilient, circular, and local value chains that can withstand external shocks such as COVID-19. At Takachar, we have embarked on the journey to impact 30 million farmers worldwide, create $2 billion per year of rural value, and mitigate 2 million tons of smoke emissions by 2030. However, our lives are linked, and we cannot achieve this impact alone. We need more scientists, innovators, entrepreneurs, policymakers, and governments to come together to pay attention to this problem, to have an impact on a planetary scale quickly. The air quality in many parts of the world are just not acceptable. I urge you to call out this injustice and challenge the status quo. Let us work together with farmers like Deepa and Kuldeep to develop innovative solutions. Let us become co-creators to clean our air and prevent carbon emissions by harvesting value from agricultural and forest wastes.